Hi, I'm Lee, and this week on NASA Now, they've been called the hurricanes of space weather, solar storms. So what's protecting us on Earth from the effects of huge explosions from the sun? The answer's ahead. But first, let's find out what's happening at NASA Now. It's official, the sun is a sphere. NASA's twin stereo probes have moved into position on opposite sides of the sun, and they are now beaming back uninterrupted images of the entire star front and back. It's the first time scientists can watch solar activity in its full three-dimensional glory. And the Glory spacecraft had some extra cargo. Designed and created by college students around the country, NASA last week launched these small research satellites as part of the educational launch of NanoSatellite, or the ELENA mission. The satellites are called CubeSats because of their shape. They are 4 inches long and weigh 2.2 pounds, 1 kilogram or less. These CubeSats will conduct technology demonstrations, educational and science research. Now it's time to take a look at the past.
October 25th, 2006. That's when STEREO was launched. The Solar Terrestrial Relations Observatory consists of two space-based observatories. They are in unique orbits around the Sun, one slightly ahead of Earth's orbit, where we will be in 3 months, the other trailing behind, where we were 3 months ago. The rocket used to launch STEREO wasn't able to place them in exact orbit, so NASA scientists used the moon's gravity to move them so that they can capture all sides of the sun.
Solar storms have been called the hurricanes of space weather. How do they affect us here on Earth? And what impact do they have on the International Space Station? Here with the answers is solar physicist Holly Gilbert.
My name is Holly Gilbert. I am the Associate Director for Science for the Heliophysics Science Division. As a solar physicist, what I do is study the very dynamic behavior, such as the solar storms, what we call flares and erupting prominences, and how those are actually being initiated, what's happening with what we call solar storms and eruptions from the sun. So a solar storm are these huge explosions of energy from the sun. You have magnetic field lines that are getting twisted and tangled. If you can imagine a rubber band, and if you twist up a rubber band, eventually it wants to snap. And that's what happens with solar storms when magnetic field lines on the sun get all twisted and tangled up, is they snap and release this energy from in terms of magnetic energy, and they also create a lot of heat, what we call thermal energy. Solar storms can affect the Earth when they're directed towards us. So sometimes there's this massive amount of what we call a plasma, which is very hot gas streaming away from the sun at over 1 million miles an hour. And this magnetic energy in the form of a bubble that comes away from the sun. And when that hits the Earth, it can interact with the Earth's magnetic field called the magnetosphere. Just like when you deal with magnets, the Earth has a very large magnetic field that surrounds it and protects it in a bubble. And so it protects us from these solar storms that are directed from the sun to the Earth. When they impact the Earth, we're protected from the very energetic particles and the magnetic field lines because it bumps into the magnetic bubble of the Earth. Since the ISS is located above the Earth's atmosphere, it's not as protected as we are here at the surface. So when solar storms hit the ISS, some of the electronics can be affected, and the astronauts can be put into protective shells. So they have protection on ISS, but they don't necessarily want to be out doing spacewalks. However, the magnetic field of the Earth is protecting them somewhat since they are in low Earth orbit. Although we're protected here at the Earth on the surface, astronauts are outside of the atmosphere, which protect us from the extra radiation from solar storms. So if an astronaut is out on a spacewalk or on the moon where there's no atmosphere to protect them and no magnetic field to protect them, they can get a very high dose of radiation and can suffer from radiation sickness, and in the extreme cases could even potentially face death. The storms that we experience on Earth, like tornadoes and hurricanes, really directly affect our lives and can be very damaging to our lives and our health. Solar storms can indirectly affect us in that they affect our technology, our cell phones, our electric grids. So it's not quite as a direct of an effect, but we still want to be able to predict it so that we can do things to at least mitigate some of those effects.
Do you know that the center of the sun is about 27 million degrees Fahrenheit? Well, that's 15 million Celsius. Now you know.
Now it's time to check out what's up.
The month of March is a good time to see what we call the zodiacal light. About an hour after sunset, it will appear like a tilted and rounded pyramid of iridescent pearly light. The light is caused by the sunlight bouncing off all the particles of dust trapped in the plane of our solar system. All you need is a location far from artificial lights.
Hey, now that you know what solar storms are and how they can affect objects in space, it's your turn to help our astronauts know when a solar storm is coming.
Create your own Space Weather Action Center weather report. All of the materials, examples, and step-by-step processes are available right here in the NASA Explorer School's virtual campus.
Well, that's it for NASA Now. Be sure to tune in next week when we'll learn about the Messenger mission. See you then on NASA Now.
NASA Now comes to you from the virtual campus at NASA Explorer Schools.